Hey everybody, it's John. Welcome over here to the workbench today. And this is what my workbench looks like right here. If yours doesn't look kind of junky like that, well, maybe you're not building enough. All kidding aside, this is my little room over here that my wife gives me. And I've got my ham shack over the other bench. And then I use the workbench right here to actually do some projects. And speaking of projects, and I've got a video series coming out on this shortly. I was recently in Branson, Missouri at the 2018 Ozark Con, which if you've not attended, I really encourage you to look into that. And hopefully I'll meet you there next year. It's a great gathering of QRP and builders. And we just get together for a weekend of fun and fellowship in Branson, Missouri. Check it out, 4-State QRP, and hope to see you there next year. While I was there this year at Ozark Con, they introduced a new kit, and it's called the Hilltopper 20. As I started building that, I started to lay out the circuit board. And some of you may have been looking for different vices or different holders for circuit boards. And it just dawned on me, this is an old trick and it's been around for a long time, but perhaps you may have missed it. If not, join me right over here on the workbench and I'll show you how you can make a PC board holder while you're constructing stuff for less than a dollar. Join me right over here. I've got you at an angle looking over the shoulder here. And try to get this thing in frame here. What this is, these are just 6/32 screws, and they're 1¼ inches long. You can use longer. I don't know that I'd go any shorter than that, but they're 6/32. And what you do, you just double nut them up next to the circuit board itself. Almost all circuit boards that you're going to be building that have kits and so forth are going to have the little holes at the end of the, or rather in the corner of the PC board. So you just put your bolt through, your machine screw through, and tighten it up. And as far as getting it level, it doesn't really have to be totally level because you're just going to be using it to go from one side to the other as you put your parts through on the through hole and so forth. So that's a pretty good tip, and I use it an awful lot. I've got I've got the third hands that we all have, and then I've got some other gadgets that hold PC boards. But when I'm just working with something, it works on any size as long as you've got the four corners covered. So that's it, W5CYM. We'll either see you on the air or we'll meet you right back here at the workbench. 73.